So you're looking for tricks to enhance the video footage you generate with Sora AI? Well, you're in the right place, because in this video, I'll break down the exact prompts you can use to change the camera, style, and lighting of a video to your heart's content. Let's dive in.
If you're new to Sora, you might know what you want, but not how to describe it, especially if you don't come from an art or cinema background. So to achieve the desired effect, you have to learn some basic cinematic terms. We'll break these terms down into 5 different categories, starting with the position of the camera. All of these videos are created by Sora. You'll see the term in the top left and the prompt at the bottom. Close-up highlights detail and emotion. Over the shoulder adds context and depth. High angle shots make the subjects look smaller and vulnerable, but low angle shots make them look more imposing or powerful. Bird's eye view is usually straight down, but in this case, it's actually from a bird. If you actually want a bird's eye view, tell Sora you want an overhead shot instead. Here, you feel the tension because the camera is tilted at a Dutch angle. A medium shot frames subjects from the waist up, and a wide shot captures a large area, so you can provide context and setting. Next, let's go through some terms that describe how the camera moves. A pan is a camera rotation left or right. A camera tilt is also a rotation up or down. I'm sure you know zoom in and zoom out already. So here they are in 2 different contexts, zooming into the sun and zooming out from an angry bear. Tracking shots follow a subject as it moves through the scene. You can make these shots more dynamic by changing them to trucking shots so the camera moves left and right. Here the camera moves in a circular motion around these 2. You can use handheld or shaky to induce a sense of fear and panic. Contrast that with a cinematic view, which you'd see on nature documentaries or opening sequences. And finally, a fun one is the tilt shift, which makes big objects look really small. Up next is film style. This really impacts the vibe of the clip. Here's something shot on a modern cell phone compared to something shot on a cell phone in the mid-2000s. It's a good way to date your clips too, like with this Civil War reenactment. Other dated looks include the bright colors of the 1950s. And for some added fun, play around with silent film. Or even vintage or archival footage, like you're playing it direct from the film. And finally, no film style would be complete without the GoPro. Next up is color grading. You can use color to evoke certain emotions and feels during a scene. For example, a snowy scene with cool tones feels more serious, versus a similar scene with warm tones feels a bit more comforting. You can add some humor to a serious situation by using pastel tones. And with monochrome palettes, you can remove distractions that are normally caused by color. For example, this green is so famous that 95% of you are going to feel something related to the Matrix. Black and white is the classic monochrome and evokes a sense of the past. And this bleach bypass effect sucks out the color to make it feel gritty or dark. Versus if we super saturate, you get these really rich colors. And last but definitely not least, we are on to lighting. First up is high key lighting. It makes the presenter feel uplifting and approachable. Contrast this with low-key lighting, which looks more dramatic and moody. You can use chiaroscuro to create harsh contrast between shadow and light, and then switch entirely to fire pits to create a warm, intimate setting. You can have the same scene with diffuse light to make it appear more soft and gentle. Shadows in this setting evoke intimacy and also a little mystery. Moonlight, on the other hand, creates calm or even subtle unease. Backlighting is fun to make characters appear to glow, especially in cold environments. Lens flares, especially in space, give off a dreamy or sci-fi feel. Moving on to shadows now, you can use clouds for a sense of impending doom. And you can also use shadows and facial expressions to create tension in the scene. Don't forget about spotlights and different colors of spotlights for the right mood. And finally, you've got a great big orange ball in the sky to create natural light.
Now, if you're looking for a step-by-step tutorial to put this all to use, check out our Sora AI video for beginners in the top right. This is David, and I'll see you there.